Welcome to tutorial on buffer overflow. Let us first understand what buffer overflow is. Let's say for example, I have this simple C code where I have created a buffer of size 10 and someone tries to write into this buffer at location 20. So what will happen in this situation? Depending on what resides at the memory location at this buffer 20, it might overwrite into either user data or user code, or it may overwrite into system data or system code. If it overwrites into user data or user code, there may not be much of a problem. Only user data or user code will be overwritten and some user data and user code will be affected. But if it overwrites into system data or system code, then it may create a lot of problems. What can happen in a typical attack scenario? Let's say we have a lot of web-based systems where user enter data into web forms. This data from the web form is sent to the server. If server writes this data into the buffer without checking the length of the input data, then the data may overflow from the buffer. So sometimes this overflow can enable an attack. So web form attack could be carried out by anyone with simple internet connection. Let's see an example of simple buffer overflow attack. We know that authentication is binary, so there is a boolean flag which actually is used to indicate whether user is authenticated or not. So let's say there is a boolean flag into the system memory. If attacker is able to overwrite this boolean flag with the help of buffer overflow and he overwrites this with let's say true, then the authentication can be actually bypassed. So here is a sample C program with buffer overflow problem, which I would like all the students to actually try out in the lab. Now here what we have done is created two character pointers. One is PTR, the other is DPTR, which I'll refer it as danger pointer. So what is happening is we are creating and allocating 10 characters to PTR and 10 characters to danger pointer. And for the sake of understanding, we are printing the address of this PTR and address of this danger pointer, right? And then there is a prompt to enter a string from the user, and this string reads some string in pointer PTR, right? And then this command is system command, which actually takes the contents of this danger pointer and executes this command in DOS mode. Let's see what will happen if I execute this program. So if you can look at this, the program prints the address of pointer. Let's say it is 1600. Then it prints address of danger pointer. It is 1614. And then if the user enters this kind of string, this is actually overflowing the buffer. If you look at the address of this danger pointer, it is actually 1614. So if user enters this string beyond 14 characters, it is actually going here in PTR, but the overflow goes to this danger PTR because it is allocated beyond this PTR. So what will happen? This DIR will actually go into this danger PTR. So when you give system and danger pointer, it will actually execute this DIR command. So if you look at this, this is the output of DIR command. So like this, the attacker can actually overflow this buffer with any DOS command. It can be format, it can be delete star dot star,
or for that matter any command. So this is the problem of buffer overflow in a C program, illustrated by a simple example. I will now suggest all the students to explore other types of buffer overflow attacks. There is one attack called as snack smashing and its prevention, and buffer overflow in web-based systems. I suggest students to explore these kinds of attacks and also understand various preventive measures for buffer overflow attacks. Thank you very much.